Welcome to George's School of Learning.
Is that any good, that timber?
No, it's not actually timber, it's just fibres. I'll show you why. Now, you know the principle of how a tree goes and you've got the annual rings like winter and summer grape, right?
Yeah, yeah.
With a palm, it doesn't happen. What happens is, it grows from the roots, it forms a head, which forms the circumference of the tree, then it starts growing up. So all it really is fibres like that.
Yeah.
And it doesn't have proper structure like a proper tree has. So there's no actual cells of timber. It's what they call scattered vascular bundles, which basically means instead of having the cambium layer around the ellipsoid, which flows all the water from the roots to the leaves and back again, this has all these scattered dots through the trunk that does exactly the same thing. So once you take the crown out of a palm, you've got a dead tree.
Yeah, right.
So once you cut the head out of it and you've got that block down the backyard there, that's the base piece of the crown shaft, what they call the crown shaft, where all the head comes out.
Yeah, right.
Once you come below that, that's dead. They won't grow again at all. Yeah. All right, but these things don't have proper structure like trees do, and because of the fibres in the tree, or in this,
yeah,
they take the edge off the saw pretty quick smart.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
You usually, with one of these, depending on how much cutting you got to do, you could probably go halfway through this and stop and having to sharpen the saw up again because it's just nulled it off, right? Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, right.
Like, it doesn't seem much, but if you imagine all these little fibres bundled together like that, and then pulling apart that way is fine. Trying to pull it apart that way, that's like rope.
Yeah.
It won't break.
Yeah, gotcha.
All right, so that's the hardest part at the moment. And the other thing is, because he was up the head, he was having trouble because of the compression and tension of the head, he couldn't put the saw in. So he's had to do what we call a plunge cut, where he comes in with a saw at an angle like that. He'll do a cut, say, in the middle of the trunk, then he'll swing his saw out and plunge all the way through with a bar and cut from the middle to the outside, and then cut from the middle to the outside again to relieve the pressure that's pushing down on the bar.
Right.
That's why he's doing the way he's doing it at the moment. He's never actually cut one of these down before, and I'm amazed about that.
Yeah, right. Why?
40 years I've been doing these, mate. I couldn't tell you how many hundreds of these things I've done.
Yeah.
But usually, as a rule, I would cut down the center like that to relieve the tension, then come in from one side. And then once you've got one block off, then you've got a gateway to the inside out, so to speak. And that makes it easier rather than fight from the outside with the compression pushing down on the bar like that all the time.
Yeah.
So the idea is punch, cut through, come from the center out, righto, off with the block, away you go again. So these things don't have what we call woody structure. Mm. It's just a layer of fibers and fibers just mixed together to make like an oversized rope trunk. See all this? This is the crown shaft piece. That's where the crown was on the top with all the fronds growing out like that.
Yeah.
He's come off there. That's the center. See that there? If he'd come down to there and cut through there, he would have killed the palm.
Oh, okay.
All right, once he comes down past there, that's dead now. You can see all these.
Yep.
See how these do this?
Yep.
Then he's trying to cut a saw in through this. So all these are trying to do, it's trying to close back up on itself again. And that's what he's fighting with.
Yeah, right.
Now that he's on the trunk now, it's just a case that you've got the grains going straight up and down.
Yeah.
So now he can cut through.
Yeah.
All right, so the worst part is doing the head, and once you get the head off and you come maybe a couple of feet below the head, then you just get down to the straight trunk like this, which makes it a whole lot easier.
Yeah.
Because they're nice and fragile, they impale themselves into your arm. This is a quick demo. That lump there is from a date palm they got in my arm when I was Jake's age, so it was probably mid-20s. And it's a piece probably about that long, about 5 or 10 mil thick, and it snapped off. Then you got a friend for life.